Hello everyone, this is Hoda Genji. In the last video, we talked about the floor design in the package A1 of SB-12 of the Ontario Building Code. In this one, I want to talk about package A3. So if you take a look at the table 3.1.1.2a, for the floor effective RSI, we have 5.64 instead of 5.25. Also for the nominal, it's a different value, it's 6.16. Now I want to show you how we can get these numbers. So I want to go to my exposed floor tab. I want to copy and paste these items. So in this one, I want to work on package A3. So this time, the value that we need to change is the RSI for the lumber joist plus the insulation layer, right? So if we want to take the difference, we want to get 5.64 at the end. So 5.64, and we have 5.25, right? So the difference between the two values is 0.39. That means to this value, 4.46, we need to add the difference between the two. So we should have 4.85 for the effective RSI for this layer. Now, if I go back to the NRCAM website under floors over unheated space, you see this was 2x4. I want to scroll down to get to 2x10 that we had, 2x8, 2x10. So before we had 5.64 for the nominal, right? And that gave us 4.46, which is here 5.64, and under 16 inches of space is going to give us 4.46. Now this nominal should be 6.16. As you see here, the nominal should be 6.16, and then the effective should be this. So if I go back to the website, I should follow this row, which is about 6.16, for the value of the nominal RSI. Okay, now let's see. If I go with 6.16, if I go with the same 2x10 frames and they're spaced every 16 inches, the RSI is going to be 4.85, and this one is the effective one. So if I get back here, what I need is 4.85, so that exactly makes sense, right? So I'm going to go with lumber joist, 38 by 235, which is 2x10, is still 406 millimeters, which is center to center of the distance between the joists, and RSI this time is 6.16, as you see here. So I want to type 6.16 here. The rest is the same. And this value is 4.85. So this is going to be 4.85. And you see we got 5.64. That's exactly what we wanted to get. So when you go to new package, the layer that you need to change is actually this one. And you need to take care of both nominal and the effective one. Okay, that's the two things you need to consider. So I want to put these two items as the suggested. We're going to go with 6.16 and we get 5.64. And when you draw the detail, it's basically exactly the same, except that here for this note, you need to say this is 6.16. The dimensions are the same because the joists are the same, the layers and everything is the same. It's just a matter of a different insulation with a different nominal value.